Dual mode IQ LPF design. The main requirements of this LPF are the attenuation of the outband signals, the inband ripple, the dual mode operation with accurate cutoff frequency controlling and accommodation to the large input ABB voltages. According to the sampling rate of a common UWB DAC, the LPF should have an attenuation of about 45 dB from 264/132 of a MHz to 600/300 of a MHz at 264/132 of a MHz mode. Moreover, an in-band ripple of half a decibel is required. To obtain comparably good phase linearity, the fifth order Kepyshev GMC LPF is proposed. Besides, to deal with the ABB voltage as large as 300 mbppm, the passive subfilter is placed as the first stage and the high Q biquad is as the last stage. Also, to improve the linearity of the LPF under low supply voltage with low power, the transconductors are built with a NADA structure, NADA B, et al., 1992. Architecture of the fifth order Kepyshev LPF with mode switch circuits. Upconversion mixer design. The simplified IPath schematic of the up mixer is shown in Fig.11. It utilizes two double-balanced Gilbert cells with their output summed to realize single sideband, SSB, upmixing. Since the IQ upmixer acts as IQ modulator and upconversion mixer in direct conversion transmitter, the performances of the transmitter are mainly determined by this circuit. Low spurs, high linearity and wide bandwidth are the main challenges for the design of this upconversion mixer. The main spurs in the output spectrum of the transmitter are the low leakage and the sideband signal. The power of the low leakage is determined by the offset of the IQ ABB path. In order to reduce the power of low leakage, an AC coupling is utilized between the V2I unit and the switches of the up mixer as shown in Figure 11. Besides, the linearity of the up mixer is mainly affected by the V2I unit while the impact of the switch stage is of less importance. Zhang Ringliang et al., 2009. Many techniques, Willie Sanson, 2006, have been proposed to improve the linearity of the V2I unit. Although the complete op-amp-assisted V2I possess better linearity, its application is restricted by the power consumption to achieve sufficient GBW gain bandwidth of the op-amp for UWB ABB as well as the limited voltage swing because of the low supply voltage. Instead, the simple op-amp-assisted V2I unit is preferred. As shown in Fig.11, the V2I unit consists of the input MOS transistor M1, the source degeneration resistor R1, the current mirror transistor M2, M3, the AC coupling capacitor CB as well as the bias resistor for eliminating the DC offset in V2I. The feedback loop is composed of M1, R1, M2, I1 and I2, where M2 acts as the simple single transistor op-amp. When applied at the gate of M1, the input ABB voltage is directed transferred to the terminals of R1, because any voltage changes at the gate will be transferred to the source of M1 to maintain a fixed VGS as required by the current source I1 and I2. Thus the input voltage is converted linearly into its current counterpart with a gain of 1/R1. The converted current I circulates in M2. Then it is mirrored into the up mixer by M3. A 400 ohm 1 South African rand is used to improve the linearity at the cost of the gain loss in V2I. To compensate it, a 6 dB gain is set at the current mirror. Furthermore, a broadband operation of the mixer is achieved by employing a differential inductor LD to peak with a parasitic capacitance PAR and two series resistors Rs to reduce Q of the overall load network. Simplified IPath schematic of the up mixer and its wideband load network.